Okay, so in today's class, we are going to start with SQL Server Reporting Services, okay, SSRS, second module. So let me introduce the SSRS architecture first, then we are going to see what are the phases available in the SSRS, then we are going to create one SSRS project, okay. So first of all, let me show you one picture for the SSRS architecture, okay. So there are different types of components available in the SSRS also, in SQL Server Reporting Services. So when you successfully install SSRS in your system, then probably you should have all these components, but you can see only only Report Manager and Report Server DB. So rest of them are inside internal components. Like authentication extension, data processing extension, and report items and all. Okay, so let me go ahead and show you the SQL Server Management Studio. So if you expand the databases node, see, you will be able to see two databases. One is Report Server database, and another one is Report Server TempDB database. Okay, if you expand this, a lot of tables will be available. Okay, and this also, Report Server TempDB. See, so these are the two databases are mandatory in order to execute the SSRS reports, because Report Server is a permanent database where all your reports will be stored permanently in this database. Okay, so .rdl is the extension for the reports. Whatever SSRS reports you are designing using Visual Studio, those will be saved permanently with the extension called RDL, Reporting Definition Language. Okay, so Report Server TempDB is for temporary purpose, like execution cache, snapshots, session information. These are all temporary information. Whenever you close the session, so that will be gone. So that kind of temporary information, in order to execute the SSRS reporting services, will be stored in the Report Server TempDB. So these two databases are important. Now, Report Manager. So there is a web application tool called Report Manager. So using that Report Manager, we are going to interact with the reports which we have already deployed into the Report Server database. Okay. So I told you we are going to design reports with the help of Visual Studio. Once we design the reports, we are going to deploy those reports into this Report Server database using the Report Manager web application tool. So how we are going to open that Report Manager web application tool? So let me show you. So just go to the all programs and let's go to SQL Server 2012 and click on configuration tools. Here we have a option called Reporting Services Configuration Manager. So right click on it, run as administrator. So for SSRS, make sure whenever you open any application, right click on it and run it as administrator, even Visual Studio also. Okay, now click on connect. This is your instance. I think Vaishnavi has attended the class. Okay, no problem. So, right, see, when you observe this, report service status started. It has started. That means already it is started. Reporting services are started. Always it should be started. Okay, if it is not started, then you can click on start button. If you want to stop it, you can stop it. Now go to web service URL. See, under web service URL, there is a URL link is there. Okay, so it is pointing to the report server. See, this is the folder name, this is the virtual directory name, report server. When you click on it, it is going to the default browser. So Google Chrome is the default browser, that is why it is getting open in the Google Chrome. But always it is recommended that open it in the Internet Explorer. Okay, so just right click on Internet Explorer icon, again right click, run as administrator. Now copy this, paste it here, close it. Paste it here, click on enter. Let me close this. We are just trying to connect to the report manager. So report manager is nothing but a web application tool. Okay. See, it is opening Sudhakar report server. That means this is working fine. Okay. So you have two folders here. One is data sources, another one is SSRS class 22. So if you double click on data sources, it is going to open what data source that is available under that particular folder. This is your folder name and this is your data source name. So I'm going to show you what is data source and all. So don't worry about that. Let's go to the back. See, if you open SSRS class 22, double click on it. See, different types of reports are there. Cascading parameter, charts modified, lot of reports are there. See, this is report server URL, okay? But this is not a report manager. We have report manager URL also separately. So I'm going to show you that. But if you click on this any report, then what will happen? See, it is going to execute that report. It is going to execute that report. But in real-time scenario, you do not have access to this particular report server URL. Here you are the administrator, that's why you have access. See, let me select any year, click on view report. I'm just providing the year as a parameter, so report is going to be executed. See, it is showing different types of charts for that particular year. If I change it to 2008 and view report, so you have data like this. So this is some sort of dashboard we have created in the previous class. Okay, we are going to do all these things. Now let me show you report manager URL also. This is report server URL, and if you go to the report manager URL, here it is showing. See, virtual folder name is what? Reports. It was report server and it is reports only, simply. So let's click on it and copy it. Go to the Internet Explorer, click for another tab. Now paste it here. See, we are connecting to the report manager. So this is your report manager URL. Okay. So we are going to manage all the reports which we have deployed into the report server database. Okay, with the help of report manager. So see here, if you open it, data sources is going to open. The only one data source is created here. If I go into the SSRS class 22, we are going to see all the different types of reports are there, SSRS reports. Simple. Okay, now, so we know how to open the report manager URL, and let's see what are the different components available in the SSRS architecture, okay? And what really happens whenever you execute the report? Because I showed you the report manager URL. If client wants to execute the report, what he will do? Directly he will ping that URL. He will open that URL and he will select that report and click on that. So automatically report will get executed. Like this, some reports will have parameters, input parameters, so you have to select year, something like that. Some of them are not having parameters, so directly it is going to deliver the data. See, you got the data. Now if you want to save it into Excel or PDF or CSV or XML, any format, you can select that. You can select Excel and click on download. Simple. So this is what happens. But thing is, when the moment you click on sales report, it is executing, right? It is loading it. Some sort of loading symbol is there, right? So what it happens back in backend, it is going to connect to the data source, the database. What is the source data? There are some source tables. From there you are going to extract the data then you are creating some sort of layout, and you are combining the layout with the data which was already extracted, then it is going to give you the report layout information, okay, final report. Then if you want to render this report into Excel, then you can download it into Excel file. So this is what happens. So same thing will be explained here in the SSRS architecture. I told you we have a report server database and report server template, and we have a web application called Report Manager. So apart from these two, there are extensions. 5 extensions are there. First one is authentication extension, data processing extension, and the report items and rendering extensions, then delivery extensions. Okay. So now the moment you click on that report button in this folder in SSRS class 22, the moment you click on it, so it is loading, right? So it is loading. So the backend process, what it will do? First of all, I am the user. Okay. So it is going to check for the authentication credentials. So whether this particular user, Sudhakar user, is having access to the database or not, it will check. If I am having access, then it will send that information to the report processor. The report processor will send that request to the data processing extension. That means, yes, this particular person is having access to the database. So you can process the data, you can get the data using that backend query. Okay. So after getting the data, report processor will send that information, that data, to the report items. So report items will have an intermediate report format. Intermediate report format in the sense, some sort of layout. How many columns are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, there is some blue color applied for the headers. Okay, so this sort of format will be already saved in the report items. Now, report processor will combine both data that is extracted by the, with the help of data processing extension, and report items intermediate report which was already developed by the report items. So it is going to combine both of them, and it will send that information to the rendering extension. Okay, so this is an intermediate report format only. That means it will be in some format, but it is not rendered yet. We are not rendering that report into some fixed format like Word format or PDF format or Excel format, because we haven't selected it. So based upon the user selection, rendering extension is going to render that report on permanent basis in a specific format. If I select Excel, then rendering extension will do that part. That is what will be happening in the backend. Once rendering is done, report processor will send that information to the delivery and scheduling processor. Delivery and scheduling processor will deliver the report. Okay. So here we are manually executing the report and we are manually downloading the report into Excel format. But we have an option in order to automate the delivery of the report with the help of subscriptions. Okay. There is a concept called subscriptions. So subscriptions are nothing but automatically deliver the report to the client on a specific time through email or Windows file share mode. So email means you will get an email with the attachment in the Excel file or PDF file, whatever it may be. Okay, on a specific time, whatever recipients will be mentioned in the email delivery, so those recipients will get that email at that particular specific time, at that point of time. Okay. So that is one type of delivery, email delivery. Another delivery is what? Windows file share. So generally in organizations, you will have a shared folders, right? So shared folders will be accessible by group of people or individual people, where if you save any file in that particular shared folder, so automatically a group of people will be able to access that file. So rather than sending the same attachment, same Excel attachment to the 1,000 people, rather than sending like that, simply they will keep that Excel file in some shared folder. All these 1,000 people will have access to that network folder. So they are going to open it and they are going to use that file. Okay. Sometimes if you have a huge size of Excel files are there, in such case what they will do, they will keep it in the network folders. Then they are going to provide access to those people. So they will access that rather than sending it to the email. So this is what delivery is. So delivery extension is going to handle those subscriptions. Okay, so this is what is the process. Whenever you execute the report, so these are the steps will be performed in backend within a fraction of seconds. Okay. So any doubt so far, SSRS architecture, what delivery extension will do, what is reporting processor, and what this entire process is. Is it clear? Okay, fine. Vaishnavi, any doubts? Okay. Right, so let me close this, and the thing is, okay, let me give you what are the three phases which are available in the report generation, report designing. Okay, so let me open Excel. Phase 1, phase 2, and phase 3. Okay, so in the first phase, we call it as a authoring phase. This is authoring phase. Okay, so second phase is what? Management phase. And third one is delivery phase. That's it. So in authoring phase, first part is we are going to design the report. Okay, designing report using Visual Studio, and we are going to deploy the report with the help of report manager. You have seen the report manager URL, right? So designing and deploying the report. After deploying the report into report manager, so we have designed the report by creating a project and we have deployed it into the report manager. See, this is your report manager. So we have created one folder and we deployed all those reports into report manager. Fine. Now we are going to manage them with the help of report manager. Okay. So management point of view, we are going to create a subscriptions. Okay, we can create subscriptions and we can create cache or snapshots. Okay, and we can provide security permissions to the users. These are all comes under management phase. So subscriptions, I have already told you, these are like automating the delivery of the report. So in yesterday's class, we have created jobs, right, in SSIS, SQL Server Agent jobs. So what a SQL Server Agent job does, it automatically executes the SSIS packages based upon the schedule time. So just like that, subscriptions also like automating the delivery of the report on a specific time, on a scheduled time. That is what subscriptions. So cache and snapshots are nothing but, rather than running the original report, we are just creating a copy of the report. So those are called cache and snapshot. But why we need to create a copy? Sometimes if your report is taking too much time, so like it is taking 2 hours or 3 hours time. So if another user comes and executes the report, again it is taking 2 hours, 3 hours time, even though there is no change in the backend data. So at that time, if you want to increase the performance of the reporting services, then probably you can create a copy of the report whenever it runs for the first time. Then the copy will be available for the rest of the users whenever they run it next time, unless until the data changes. Okay, so that type of facility is called cache snapshot. So we will, both are different. Cache is different, snapshot is different, but both are like a creating copy of the original report. So we will see in detail. Okay, so security permissions. If new user comes and wants to execute the report, so they do not have permissions to execute that report, right? So because all these reports are deployed into the report server database, and if I want to provide permissions to the new user or group of users, I can use the report manager URL to provide the permissions. See here you have security permissions like that. So we will see how to do that. And delivery phase. In delivery phase, two types of deliveries are there. Two types of reports are there. First of all, one is ad hoc reports. We call it as a full type reports and push type reports. This comes under full type reports. So example is ad hoc reports. Push type reports. So full type reports are nothing but sometimes you got an ad hoc request. So this is not continuous request, or frequently you are not getting this type of request. Only this is for one time purpose. So in that case you are directly going to the report manager, and whatever report that is there, you will simply click on that report button. And manually you are downloading that file into Excel, and you will remove some columns and you will do some sort of formatting. Okay. So if you require any chart or something like that, and you will do it on your own. But you will get all the base data from the report server itself. Okay. If you do not require some columns, you will remove that. If you have some additional formatting, you will do that. So that is all ad hoc reports. Okay, on frequently if you require some that kind of report, then probably you will design that report and you will keep it in your you will deploy it in your report manager. But that is only for one time basis. That's why you are going to run it manually. That's why we call it as full type reports, and those are nothing but ad hoc reports. Okay, one time purpose. And push type reports. Push type reports are nothing but reports which are already deployed into their report manager, and you are going to create some subscriptions in order to execute them automatically. Okay, so here we are going to use subscriptions in order to deliver those reports. But delivery, again, two types of delivery are there. We have already discussed what is email delivery, and second one is Windows file share mode. Windows file share. Okay. So one is email delivery. I told you this is just like sending an email to your friends. So you are going to provide the to list, CC list, BCC list, and subject and body of the text and the file attachment, and what type of file attachment, whether it should be rendered in Excel or PDF or Word document. Your wish. Okay. So at that particular, if you provide the time schedule, at that particular time the report will be executed in the backend, and it is going to be saved as an attachment to the email, and email will be notified to the recipients list. Okay. So this is email delivery. And Windows file share, it will be saved in some network folder, that's it, rather than sending it to the email. But in our case, we will not be able to do the email delivery in our examples, because we do not have SMTP server configuration is not available now in our system, but in your office it will be available. Okay. I can show you the Windows file share mode, how to create the network folder and how to provide access to the folder and how to save that report into the Windows file share mode. Okay, so these are the three phases which are available in SSRS. Clear? Any doubts so far? Fine. Right. So, okay, fine. So, what we are going to do, let's create one SSRS project today and we will create one simple report also. Okay. So, let's go back to the Visual Studio. Let's click on New Project. Let's select the reporting services, report server project, click on browse, let me save it under SSRS folder, select the folder, I'll name it as SSRS class 23, click on OK. The moment you click on OK, it is going to create SSRS project. See, this is your project name, SSRS class 23. And we have three items, shared data source, shared data set, reports. First of all, what is data source and what is data set? Data source is nothing but you are trying to create a report. That means you are extracting data from some database, right? So what is the database? What is the server? That information will be available in the data source. This is just like a connection manager you are creating in the SSIS packages. Okay. And what is dataset? Dataset is nothing but after connecting to that particular server and database, you are going to execute some SQL statement, right? In order to execute that, in order to extract the data. So that SQL statement is nothing but a dataset. That query is nothing but a dataset. So what is shared? Shared means if you create only once, then that can be used across the project. Lot of reports might be designed, but you do not want to create each and every report, you do not want to create the separate data set and separate data source. Then you can create shared data source and shared data set, and you can use both of them across the project. But in real time scenario, each and every report will have some different query and some different data. That's why you are not going to create the shared data set, but you are going to create shared data source. Okay, so you might be pointing to the same database, but you are not going to use the same query for each and every report. Okay, now, so when you create a report, each and every report, again, it will have an embedded data source and embedded data set. You are trying to point out that embedded data source with the help of shared data source. I'm going to show you, then you will understand it perfectly. Okay, let me create shared data source first, add new item, select data source, provide some name, let's say AEW_DS, something like that. Right click, add new data source, directly it is pointing to the data source properties. Now here we need to select type of server. So I am connecting to the Microsoft SQL server only. So let me select that. If you want to get the data from Oracle or Hyperion, anything, Teradata, so you have to select that vendor. Then click on edit. See, provide the server name. And for SQL server, for SSRS examples, we are going to use the database called AdventureWorks DW22. Okay, so without this database, we are not able to do the examples because it will have almost real time data but less data. Okay, so we are going to use AdventureWorks DW22 for SSRS and SSCIS examples. For both modules, we require this database. So this database will have a lot of tables. See, we are going to use some tables. Okay, now let me select AdventureWorks DW2012 here. Click on test connection. then click on OK. Again, click on OK. See, that, let me rename that. Rename it adw_ps. Click on OK. Shared data set. So rather than creating the shared data set, we are going to create the embedded data set. Okay. So both are same, but here if you create it, so you can use that data set across the project. That is the difference. So let's right click on reports and add a new report, or you can select add under new item. So if you select add new report, what will happen? It is going to open a wizard. See? So I will show you wizard later. As of now, let's try the customized report. Add new item, select report, provide some name. Let me create sales.rdl. .rdl is the extension for the reports. Okay, .rdl is the extension. Reporting definition language. So click on add. The moment you click on add button, see sales.rdl will be created and report designer also will be opened. So this is all designer area. Okay. And left side you can see data sources, data sets. I told you each and every report again will have embedded data source, embedded data sets. So this is embedded data source, embedded data set. Okay. Now what we need to do, for every report we need to mention the data source. Right click on it, add data source. Now select the Microsoft SQL Server and go to the edit connection, again server name, again database name. But rather than doing this, already we have created a shared data source called adw_ds. Okay, so better select use shared data source reference. Select that adwds which is already created here, then click on OK. If this particular report is connecting to another database that is different than the shared data source, then you can go ahead and use the embedded connection. Unless until you can use the shared data source. So that's why I will create it only once, and every time I'm going to use that shared data source. Clear? So click on OK. So your data source name is what? Data source 1. But this data source 1 is pointing to shared data source called adwds. Okay. Now data sets. Right click on it. Add data set. Now use shared data set. See, it is showing some facility here. See, if you create a shared data set, it is going to list out those data sets here. Earlier I have created test_ds. This is a shared data set. If you want to use that, yes, you can select that and click on OK. But I don't want to use the shared data set. So I want to use data set embedded in my report. That means here I am going to use the separate different query. Okay. Select this. Now select the data source 1 that is created just now and provide the query here. See, here we have query designer. Click on that. See, this is your query designer. So let's add some tables to build the query. Okay, so if you have SQL query already available with you, then click on this edit as text. It will be converted into text mode. Okay, so you can write your query here, select star from emp, something like that, then you can execute it. Okay, so if SQL query is not available with you, then you can use the graphical user interface. Again click on that, so it will be turned into graphical user interface. So here click on add tables and let's select the some tables. So I want to select dim product, add it, dim product category, add it, dim product subcategory, add it. Then I want to select fact internet sales table, add it. That's it. Okay. Now see first pan, second pan, third pan and fourth pan. So here if you want to
hide them, then you can hide it. See, I hide it. Hidden all the things. So this is your diagram, okay? So in this diagram, let's keep it like this. Right. So now check this. Fact Internet sales table will have all the numerical data, all the facts information or measures information. So how many products you sold? See, it is having order quantity. How much you say, how much sales you have done? So sales amount. So these are all numerical items. Okay. Now I want to show the, I want to create a report that is going to show me data. What are the products which are sold? How much it is sold? What is the sales amount? And what does that product belongs to? So what is the product category and what is the product subcategory and what is the product name? So product category information will be available in the product category table, and subcategory information will be stored in this table, and DIM product, it is having product name information and all. Okay. So what are the columns you want to select? I want to select, see, let me show you the, let me enable all these boxes again. So the moment you select them, automatically it is going to create a query here, SQL query, see. Already it makes joins. So what is the common column between both the tables in order to make the join? Keep the cursor here. Product category key is the common column in both the tables. See, here we have product category key, and here also we have product category key. Here subcategory key is the common column. Here product key is the common column. Okay. Now let's select the product key, English product category name. Let's select the product subcategory key and English product subcategory name. Let's select the product key and English product category, English product name. And here, let's select order quantity. Select it and sales amount. That's it. So this is your query. If you copy this query, if you go back to the SQL Server Management Studio, let's keep the heading something like this. SSRS queries. Just give me a second. So let's paste it here and select the database called AdventureWorks DW12. Execute it. See how many records we are getting? 60,398 rows. These are all detailed data. Okay. Category 1 stands for bikes. Okay. Product subcategory 2 stands for road bikes. And product 310 road stands for road 150. Red 62. This is product name. What is the order quantity? Only one bike is sold for the amount of $3,578. Like that, we have 60,398 rows are there. Okay. So before designing any reports, try to understand the detailed data. Okay. So first of all, whatever tables we have used here, let's have a look at those tables. Okay. So DIM product. Select start from DIM product. So these are all, this is product detail. So let me take the product category. Product subcategory. DIM product is there. In fact, internet sales. See how many
So let's check the data for product category table. How many rows are there? Only 4 records are there. Okay, so in category we will have subcategories. So that means product category 1 stands for bikes, 2 stands for components, 3 stands for clothing, 4 stands for accessories. So again, bikes category will have subcategories. Okay, what are those subcategories? See, total 37 subcategories are there. Okay, so bikes category will have first 3 subcategories: mountain bikes, road bikes, touring bikes. How do you know whether it is related to the product category 1? See, here category key is there. It stands for 111. That means it's these three subcategories are related to the bikes category. It is saying 1, right? So 1 means bikes category. Like that. See, it is showing 2. Some of them are 3 and some of them are 4. Like that, we have 37 subcategories. So 4 categories, 37 subcategories, and next level is what? Products. 606 products are there. There are 606 products are there. So each and every product is related to some subcategory and some category, isn't it? So packed internet sales. If you execute this, how many records are there? 60,398 records are there. So it is showing all the data, all the detailed data. How much products you have sold? What is the quantity? What is the tax amount? What is the freight amount? All the numerical items will be available in this table. Okay, so by joining all these 4 tables, you are going to get the data like this. So here you have 3 levels. First level, highest level is what? Category. Second level is subcategory. Third level is dim product. Product level. So this is what you need to understand. Then, so let's execute this. So we are getting 60,398 rows, right? Here also we are getting same records. 60,398. Okay, if you want to, already you have SQL query, right? You have SQL query with you. So next time onwards, rather than selecting each and everything, just go to the edit as text. See, directly you will paste this here. Simply you will execute that. So you are getting the data. Then click on OK. Simple. See, you are getting the data set. So whenever you provide a name to the data set, do not include the spaces. Rather than use the underscore. Okay. So do not keep the spaces. It will not accept. The moment you click on fields, it is going to show you the field information. Okay. Column names. Then click on OK. See, under dataset 1 you have these many fields. Now what I want to do, I want to create a simple report. So go to the toolbox here. Select the table report item. Drag it here. See, whenever you drag it for the first time, it is going to show you header data. So data representing 3 lines. So 3 lines represents detailed data. And these are all headers with the 3 columns. If you want to create multiple columns, you can insert it left or right. If you want to delete it, you can delete the column. Okay. Now, let's go to the report data. See, under report data, we have a data set, right? So let us select the columns which we want to show. So we do not want the category key. We want the category name only. That's it. Okay. So let me select category name. And it is going to take the same name as a header also. And let's select the, otherwise you can drag like this also. Both are fine. And select the product name. And let me insert one more column right side and one more column right side. Select order quantity, select sales amount. These are all headers, that's why let me make it bold and let me apply some color here. Let me apply some background color blue. Okay, so if you want to move this item, yes, you can move like this. So you can move it to the corner of the report, and whatever this
unnecessary space is there, you can make it like this. So this is your perfect report, and let's see how it is look like. So let us provide some grid lines also. So we will provide some borders to the data. Where is that? Yeah, here it is, outside border. Now see the preview. See, we got the data. Same report. Whatever you will see in the report manager URL, same thing will be appeared here. Same options. You want to send it to the Excel report? Yes, you can do it. Download it. Save it. Save it on your desktop. See, this is your sales report. Open it. See? How many rows are there? 60,398 rows total. This is your report. Here. Let's close this. Right. So this is your very simple report, and I want to add one column to this report, and that is nothing but a serial ID, serial number. Okay. So we do not have serial number, right? So row ID. So what I can do? Right click on it, insert column, left side, and I will name it as row ID. Then right click on it, select expression. So we will be able to write an expression in order to get the serial number. So we have a function called, if you open this common functions, lot of functions will be there. See, text functions, datetime, math, inspection, program flow, aggregate, financial, conversion, miscellaneous, lot of functions are there. Here we have a row number function. Double click on it, otherwise you can type it. Okay, so double click on it, row number of nothing. I'm simply typing nothing. Close it. So click on OK. Now check the data. See, we are getting row ID. Okay, now at the end of the report, in the last page, how many pages are there? So many pages are there, because data is huge, right? See, if you go to the next page, it is showing page wise data. If you go to the last page, this is the last page. 60,398 rows are there, right? So here, if you want to get the grand total, then you can insert a new row. Let me insert new row. Insert row. Insert row outside group below. Select this one. See, one row is inserted here. Type grand total. Type grand total. Now select order quantity. Here you need to get the sum of the order quantity, right? So order quantity. The moment you select the order quantity, automatically it is taking the expression sum of order quantity. If it is not taking the sum of order quantity, then right click on it and go to the expressions. Then write something like this. Sum of, go to the fields data set one, under which we have order quantity. Double click on it. Close the bracket. Click on OK. So you will get this sum function in aggregate functions. See, here we have sum. You want to keep the average count? Yes, you can keep it. Okay, click on OK. Here also, sales amount. See, automatically it is taking sum of sales amount. Make them bold and see the preview. go to the last page. See, grand total 60,398 and total value, but it is not in a proper format. See, here it is an order quantity. There should be some commas, right? Comma separator should be there. And this is a dollar amount. There should be currency format, but it is not in a proper format. Here also it is not in a proper format. So what I can do, right click on the order quantity, go to the text box properties, go to the number, select the number. See, decimal places. For quantity, I don't want to keep the two decimal places. Make it zero. Use thousand separators. Click on OK. Okay. Now, for sales amount, text box properties, go to number, currency, use decimal places 2, because it is a currency format. Use thousand separators. Click on OK. Right. Now, you have applied that only for the detailed data, but for grand total column you haven't applied any number format. Okay, so let's go and see the preview. Go to the last page. Now check this. See, here you have only one value. That's the reason why it is not showing thousand separators. If you have multiple digits, then it is going to show you thousand separators. But for currency you have multiple digits, so it is showing two decimal places and dollar value comes before the value. See, it is in a perfect format. But same format if you want to apply for the grand total column also. See, for grand total row it is not applied. Okay, so if you want to copy the same format, again you have to manually right click on it, go to the text box properties, then go to the number, then select the number, right? Rather than doing that, already you did it for the above cell. Now select that particular cell, click F4 button in your keyboard. F4 will show you the properties. So in this properties, select the format. See, format property will have this option, right? So copy it. Now select this particular cell, then go to the format. Here nothing is there. Paste it here. Same format will be applied to the sum of order quantity also. Same thing. Keep the cursor in sales amount. Take the format. Copy it. Again, keep the cursor on the below cell for the sum of sales. Paste it here. This is really helpful when you have multiple cells. So for each and every cell, if you want to modify it manually, it will take a lot of time. Rather than doing that, so just change it manually for only one cell and copy the format and select all the cells for which you want to apply the same format, then paste it. Simple. Now let's check the preview. See, for grand total also it is applied. See, here we have more digits, that's why it is showing thousand separators. See, currency format also applied. So this is what the basic report we are designing. Okay, so any doubt so far? Let's save it. Controllers, any doubts? Okay, right. So, Kishore, actually, so tomorrow I'm traveling back to the Hyderabad. So, I will not be able to take the class tomorrow. And Tuesday, Wednesday also, I have trainings in the morning. So, that's the reason why we do not have classes from tomorrow till Wednesday. So, again, the next class will be on Thursday. Okay? So, I'm going to share this video with you. So you can do practicals. Okay, right. So again, next class would be on Thursday. Anyway, I'm going to send a mail. SSCS after SSRS, then we are going to do the SSCS. So still we have a lot of different types of reports. So this is a simple basic report. I need to explain a lot of things. Okay, right. Then have a nice day. Bye bye.